In today's video, we're going to be talking about what is the best temperature for sleeping. What's the best temperature specifically for sleeping? I have done the research so that you don't have to. In the studies that I looked at from the National Sleep Foundation, WebMD, on PubMed, they had some studies about sleep and temperature. The common answer for what is the best temperature for sleeping was around 65 and 70 degrees. One thing that I learned that was really interesting is that our natural circadian rhythm in our body does lower our body's temperature at night. So having a cooler atmosphere to sleep in helps your body understand that it's time for sleeping and for sleeping deeply. Our bodies have a set temperature, a set core temperature that it's trying to achieve, and it might be different for everybody. You might have to experiment a little bit. What triggered in my brain as a heating and air conditioning dispatcher is that, wow, 65 degrees is pretty cold, and it might take your furnace a long time to warm up your house after you let it drop down to 65 degrees. And so if you're trying to adjust your room temperature down to a lower temperature, maybe try things like closing off some registers by turning on a fan, by having cooler bedding or cooler pajamas instead of letting your whole house get to about 65 degrees. Because if you're wanting your house to be 72 during the day, your furnace might have to run really hard for a long time in order to achieve that temperature difference. The studies universally said that adults get better sleep when they lower the temperature in their bedrooms, especially by a couple of degrees, but that's not necessarily the case for children. So if you have children in your house, you don't want to freeze them out because they're going to sleep worse, which makes that worse for everybody during the day. There are several different options. You could just close off some registers in your room. You could install some zoning in your home to create some different zones for some different temperatures so that it won't affect the entire house. You can use fans and cooling pads, cooling blankets to only affect either just you or just your bedroom so that you're not cooling off the entire house by such a large amount. I laugh just as a heating and air conditioning person that a number of the studies said the best temperature for sleeping is 65 degrees. And in my mind, well, if it's summertime in the middle of the Midwest, there's no way you can possibly get your room to be 65 degrees when it is 100 degrees outside. Another little tool that I use in my house is this thing right here. It's an Accurite temperature gauge. It just says the temperature and humidity, and you can place this anywhere in your house. Our thermostat is in a separate area of the house, but I have this in each bedroom so that I can know exactly what the temperature is. So this is helpful. I'll link it down below. It was pretty cheap. Another helpful tip that I thought was really interesting is this Scandinavian trick for better sleep. The two duvet trick, as it's called, which is, so you have a king or queen size bed with spouses sleeping in it, and you have one duvet typically, right? But they use two duvets. They have a queen size bed, but two twins, so that each partner has their own duvet or blanket, main blanket that they're using, because you never realize just how much you're waking up the other person just by moving. And so that shifts their blanket a little bit. So I'm totally going to try this one. The trick is that you use two duvets, same color, so that they look like they go together matching on the bed, and then put maybe a common quilt or blanket around the base of the bed to make it look a little bit more cohesive. But I thought that that was a fantastic trick just for getting better sleep in general. To sum up the studies, what is the ideal temperature for sleep? It ranged, but it was basically around 65 to, I saw one study that said 72. But the key is that each individual person, their body has a set temperature that it is trying to achieve for the best sleep. And it's usually around a 2 degree difference from what your temperature is during the day. So if you can figure that out, maybe by using things like this to kind of monitor what the temperature is in your room to see what works best for you, then hopefully you get a better night's sleep, which leads to better health in general. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe, and we will see you next week. Thanks a lot.